cowboy riding bulletproof. Go to it, Big Red Hurley. Harry Ramus marks 13 seconds. And that's Morty Mead and old Big Fable, one of the honoriest framers out of the Double B Spread.
Did you find Chuck?
No, he ain't got a phone.
Well, how can a guy be a busy veterinarian and not have an office phone?
I don't know. I mean, even Ma's got a phone. Hey, miss, did you ever hear of Chuck Martin?
Sure, he's a rider.
Oh, he used to be.
He the one that won that bareback a couple years ago?
Yeah, but he ain't riding no more. He's a vet here in town. You know him?
I don't know no vets. I don't even know any animals. Now, come on, how about some eggs?
Not for me.
Sandwich?
No, thanks.
Oh, you got a lot to learn, Sonny. I mean, you and your father here. Lunch is good for you. Say, what do you mean, letting the kid get away with this?
Oh, I'm like that about all my kids. All 14 of them.
What'd you say? I mean, 14?
Remember us? Becky and I met you last year. Our riding class put on an exhibition before the rodeo.
Cindy.
Cindy Hopkins. Hey, you've grown up, son.
Thanks.
How you been, Cindy? How's Becky?
We're fine, Mitch. And Andy, I'm still in love with you.
You know you can't trust women. Everybody knows she loves Becky.
Coming up now, a barrel racing event featuring the girls from the High River Riding.
That's me. Good luck, Mitch. See you, Andy.
We'll be rooting for you, honey.
Thanks. It's nice to have someone. My folks couldn't make it. Bye.
Then we'll root double hard. Folks couldn't make it last year either, could they?
Yeah, I remember. I remember how Mama used to come down to the picnic grounds just to see me chase a greased pig. I guess some people are a little busier than they ought to be.
Yeah. Let's go watch.
And now the first contestant in the barrel roll, Cindy Hopkins.
Like that, Andy.
Just a scratch. You're lucky.
I'm lucky. Real lucky.
You're all right, huh? I mean, you got no pain nowhere.
Pain everywhere.
No, I meant...
Yeah, I know what you meant.
Look, Andy, why don't you take Cindy home and get that elbow cleaned up?
I can't leave Becky.
There's nothing you can do here, honey. No. I mean, why don't you let Andy take you home and I'll go get Chuck Martin or some other vet. Come look her over.
Going to be all right.
Well, I expect we'll have to wait and see what the doc says.
Don't put me off, Mitch. You know horses.
Just a ride, Cindy.
You tell me.
Now, hey, now look here. She's going to be all right. Now, come on.
Take in? Cindy?
Do you know what it's like, Andy? I mean, something happening to someone you love?
Now look, honey. Becky's an animal. And no matter how much you love her, you can't make her anything else.
She's not just an animal. Becky and I understand each other. If Becky dies, if she does, I don't know what I'll do.
Come on, I'll take you in. Hi, my name's Andy Guthrie. I wonder if I might talk to her mother for a minute.
She's out of town.
Oh. Did they call you from the arena?
Yes. And thank goodness she's all right.
Is she?
Her father's home.
Oh, did you tell him?
He has an important meeting in the library.
Well, don't you think he'd want to hear about it? I mean, she's pretty upset about that accident.
Look, why don't you tell him? Why don't you? He's right in there. Go on and tell him. It's about time somebody did.
All right.
I wouldn't do that, Andy.
All right. I'll go in with you. You'll want to know what happened.
And I tell you, gentlemen, if there's oil down there, it's on the other side of the world.
The geologist's report shows that once we cut through that shale...
Has he estimated the cost of cutting through that shale and the rock level below that?
I think Powell's right.
I don't agree. Every lab test indicates
that there's oil. Surface oil. Now, gentlemen, listen to me. If we cut it out, if we pull out now...
But we can't pull out. We don't want to fight with you, Powell.
Fight with me? Now, gentlemen, listen to me.
Daddy,
now, honey, Daddy is working.
I just wanted to tell you that at the arena...
Can it wait a minute, darling?
How long will you be?
Well, I don't know, honey. Now, aren't you a little out of line?
Sorry, Daddy.
Now, we'll talk about it when Daddy's finished.
Now, gentlemen, there's a great deal of money sunk in that hole. And I won't be a party to throw good money after bad. That is going to be my report. The
risk is great. I'm used to it, I guess. I mean, he's busy. What does Becky really mean to him anyway?
Well, it looks to me like if she means something to you, she ought to mean something to him, too.